So in 1996 or 97, Strapping Young Lad came through Melbourne and played some shows. And at the show, I met the bass player, Byron, and just started talking to him about what I was doing. He was telling me he was doing an industrial project. And basically, he expressed interest in working on the Berserker recording and that kind of thing. And at the time, I really didn't think too much of it, but I gave him some demos and they went back to Canada. So about a year later, Strapping came back. And you know, within that time, I'd been continuing to work on the album, and he told me that Jed, the guitarist, was interested in being involved in the project as well. And at the time, he was working on Frontline Assembly. He was their live guitarist, and I thought, oh, well, this is almost too good to be true. You know, we've got the industrial side of you know, Frontline and Unit 187, their other band. You know, with the metal side of Strapping, you know, this could almost be the perfect combination. Then Byron told me that Devin was interested in producing the album, and that I should have a chat to him. So I went and spoke to Devin, and he was reasonably excited about it and said he could make it, you know, sound huge, and that he pictured it as a rusty old junkyard after hearing the demos. And you know, I thought, yeah, this might be able to actually work. So after speaking with Devin, I spoke to Jed and Byron once again, and it seemed like they really understood what I was trying to achieve, and I finally thought, you know, I found what I've been looking for. So I was really excited about finding people who could capture my vision of what I wanted the band to sound like. Somewhere along the line, Val, the singer from Zimmer's Hole, got involved, you know, which was great. His vocals on the Zimmer's albums are fantastic, and you know, I was really looking forward to that. So it was all a bit overwhelming, I guess. I'd just signed to a label that I'd grown up listening to, you know, as a kid, and loved all the bands, and the fact that well-known musicians were interested in recording and being involved in a project that I created. We worked out that it'd be best if we recorded the album in Canada, and I set about organising my trip to Canada to record with the guys. After a 30-hour trip, my first introduction to the Canadians was a three-hour little meeting in customs, and them wanting to send me back to Australia for not having the correct working visas. Val and Byron picked me up from the airport, and we went straight down to Val's place, and I loaded up some of my equipment and found that all the industrial sounds that I'd created for the song Reality had been erased due to, I guess, airport x-ray machines. So we were off to a brilliant start. So Val, I'd never met before. Quite a risky thing to fly halfway around the world to stay with someone and work with that you've never met before. But Val's a really cool guy, you know, really laid back, always joking around, and it was good to know that at least we got on really well, seeing as I'd be spending the next couple of months staying at his house. You know, like I've said, the mood was really lighthearted, and I'd started joking about the album failing before we'd even started it.
It's day 16, things aren't going to plan. Having a lot of problems with the guys. Val won't do anything, won't get out of bed.
How can you keep a straight face and say that crap?
Hey, where is it you want me to sing like a poofed little pixie? Whereabouts is that? You know, the little voice? La 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 la. Is that how you want that to go? Okay, I think I got that part nailed.
Do you see what I mean? Just things aren't going well.
So it was kind of funny, I'd sent Val all the lyrics, you know, printed out all nice and clearly, and he thought that he'd be able to read it a lot better if it was in his own handwriting, so he spent the next couple of hours, you know, rewriting all the lyrics.
Gaze upon it! For it is an epic novel! In one fucking song!
We just set up a room in Val's house to start the vocal rehearsals, to set up some mics and stuff, and basically went at it.
My last roar! My life taken away. It will retain the skills of, because that is our only way.
Here's a shot of my room at Val's place, where Val has graciously put me up. Byron's giving me his futon mattress, which is really cool. May have some problems with the recording. Jed was having a chat about money and stuff today. Obviously, we have a misunderstanding?
So basically our communication, I guess, wasn't so good. Within the first meeting with Jed, he asked for an advance in the recording money. And I mean, this took me as a bit of a surprise. I was under the impression that, you know, they were going to help me with the Berserker album, and I was going to help them with the Zimmer's Hole album.
I don't know, we'll just have to see what happens. But he doesn't seem as enthused as he once was. Starting to think, should do Sam and Paul and done it in Australia. This came as a little shock, so see what happens. Hopefully it all turns out in a couple of days. I'm talking about it a little different. Things didn't go as smoothly as planned today. Yeah, starting to regret a lot of things. Devin's talking about pulling money out of the recording to pay the guys, which is going to fuck the recording. The guys never asked for any money. They saw something in a pre-budget I was talking to Earache about, and I mean, fuck me, Dad, I don't do business like this. This is bullshit.
I mean, looking back on it, the first thing that I should have done is had contracts written up and signed by everyone so there'd be no doubt about, you know, people's positions and what they had to do. But I didn't see the point at the time for legalities and just saw it as musicians helping out musicians, you know, which I was used to.
Hey, it's now Thursday. I've had a chat to Devin and all the rest of it. I'm thinking to sample individual riffs.
I was trying to think how I could make things easier for the guys to record this album, and what I came up with was to get them to play each riff once, and then I'd sample it and take it to a friend's studio in Germany and put it back together. And that meant less studio time for them, but I guess more work for me in the long run.
Maybe it's going to be a better way. I just have to have a talk to Devin about relinquishing the money. And he still hasn't been paid that. We're supposed to be in the studio at 6 o'clock tomorrow.
Yeah, so we finally got into the studio, and it quite quickly became apparent that Devin and myself had very different ways of working. He wanted to track all the electronic drums, which we did, but I like to keep them running via MIDI so that we can change sounds if perhaps they're not working, or we find something that has a little bit more impact.
Keep her coming. Oh, there's no headphones.
Oh, there's no headphones!
So we started on the guitars, and again, we had very different opinions on how things should sound. I was after an old Colin Richardson death metal sound, big, thick gauge strings, and, you know, wall of Marshalls kind of thing. And Jed had his normal strings and his own idea of how he thought the riffs should be played. And I guess, again, it's a communication problem. I thought I'd done everything in my power, you know, to make sure that they knew what I was after by playing them, you know, Old Carcass and talking about, you know, thick gauge strings, 58s as the low E and that kind of thing. But I guess music's such a subjective thing. I mean, at the time I thought I'd explained everything perfectly clearly, but when we kind of got into it, it was quite apparent that we were both on very different pages.
Didn't hit it.
I didn't hit it, man.
That was nice. I liked that.
You like that?
Yeah, it was cool.
Guitars didn't work. We're getting the wrong tone. We're getting the bass tone. Devin is unfamiliar with the conversation that we had in Australia about the about him being able to get that, work with the kicks and all the rest of it, which he said was no problem, which he does not remember the conversation. And obviously anything that I said to Jed, well, whatever, because he didn't have the right gauge strings and we were getting a completely different sound, and it's obvious we need a Marshall, not a Mesa Boogie. So we gave the vocals a little bit of a try, but I mean, it's a bit, it was a little rushed, so we're going to, I think the plan is we're going to try and do the vocals here.
At this point, I was really struggling with what to do next. You know, over the past week, I'd seen all of my plans come undone, and I was not in the best frame of mind, shall we say.
I have a 10-minute interview, if you wouldn't mind just standing back, about the last couple of days, your views and thoughts.
The velocity was rolling.
This is where Val really stepped up, just trying to keep me positive about the whole thing. And, you know, he took me out to some carnival just to try and forget about the madness of the recording for a while. And then we ended up spending the rest of the night at a video arcade. And, you know, that did help for a while.
This is the setup we've got now. Do you want to try again? Or are you going to listen to Pain?
One more time, man.
You finished for this evening?
No. You annoying camera slut!
This is the face of a man in denial. Although Val was doing his best to keep rehearsing and stay positive, I was really having a hard time just trying to deal with the whole situation. This was my first album for a big label, and everything that was going on reflected badly on me, and I was really struggling to come up with a solution.
Yeah, it's 4 o'clock in the morning. Just had a chat to Dig, Hugh and Alistair, excuse me. Just about the whole thing, and I should be cool. They're going to try and get the guitarist and whatever from Extreme Noise there. I'll look around and see what's happening in Vancouver. But hopefully the vocals will come along really well. There you go. I have faith. Just watched all the footage from the last couple of days.
In 97 or 98, I met a brilliant Australian guitarist named Paul. This guy had the perfect playing style and the most awesome guitar sound. And, you know, he wrote majority of the riffs for the tracks February Slit Down and Burnt. For anyone who has the 98 demos, that's Paul playing on there. Okay, so this guy knew everything about getting a good guitar sound. So I'd contacted him to see if he would be interested in recording on the album. Somewhere along the line, Paul had found God and distanced himself from the extreme music scene, and I just couldn't believe how many things were going wrong. I had no idea how this album was ever going to get done.
So we just got the,
Lie in the name of God! Lie!
So we just got the email from Paul there saying that he couldn't...
Deceive for Christ! Deceive for Christ!
But he couldn't be involved... He couldn't be involved in the project because of his Christian morals. Because the audience it was going to was not...
Evil, evil audience, evil!
So once again, Val had decided it was time to take our mind off things for a while. And, you know, I don't drink. And I don't drink beer. And I mean ever. But this was the exception.
Jed's got frontline rehearsal starting tomorrow. I booked in to get try and get the time with Jamie, but it's not looking like it's happening. So it's not. He doesn't want to do it. He basically doesn't want to sacrifice his sound, which is whatever. Trying to stay positive, but I mean, it's all a load of fucking bullshit. We discussed all this crap, and I wouldn't be fucking wasting my money out here if I'd known all this fucking crap. So anyway, he wants to save what's left of the friendship, so yeah, let's just do that. And now I gotta try and, well, one, I gotta cancel Jamie tomorrow, and I've got to, and the vocals, I don't even know.
So, we'll just see what happens. But I mean, I just don't even know. I just don't even know what to say or what the fuck I'm even thinking. So, but he doesn't. Anyway, he's not doing it. So I have to try and find some guitars, teach him all the fucking shit, get the sound, do it all without going back to Australia. I just don't know any guitarists that can do it. I mean, Sam will put in the hours to do it, but I don't think he can play fast enough, so that's going to cause some problems, which is a pain in the ass. Anyway, whatever.
The other thing I forgot was the everything happens for a reason. So what is that reason, we may ask? And where is the light? Well, no one knows.
I got the chicken.
Let's go back to the dance bar, but everyone's gone, huh? And no note on the door, so looks like I'm going to have a bit of a walk back to Chris's place, which should be a bit of fun.
This is our setup. We got the mic here.
So the way we were trying to record was straight to the mini disc, and that meant no punch-ins whatsoever.
And using this desk as a preamp, and then recording onto the mini disc.
It's the 13th today, and things are, I suppose, starting to get a little better. Jed's not doing the recording. Oh yeah, we've already established that. Okay, so we rang Cam today. We're going to try and get him to do it, and he was going to give us a call back. But he didn't give us a call back. So Byron came over, and on his way here, he bumped into Patrick, who got off the train, from JC and Punch Drunk. Anyway, he came over after work, and he's into it. He's up for the job. It's interesting how stuff happens, but there's a faint glimmer of hope on the horizon.
Patrick is about the only guy in town, he reckons, that doesn't use EMG pickups, so thank fucking God, huh?
Yeah, it's an interesting day, interesting experience, I suppose. But he seems to want to put in the time and effort, likes to keep busy like myself, so that's sort of cool. Yeah, Patrick's coming over tomorrow to do the guitars, well, you know, so I can hear and everything, so hopefully everything's cool, and I'm not overly interested in doing the album, but... That's what happens.
Starting to feel bad that I didn't include Sam and the guys that put in the time on the project that were really into it. So, you know, Patrick's on the job. We'll see how that comes up.
Yes, you are.
You are the moron.
Thank you.
Working so hard, and all he does is to try and psychologically fuck me.
Or is it I who am fucking him?
I eat your skin.
I drink your blood.
So you
I eat your
old
skin.
The seasoned chicken. Yes, and what's happening with the seasoned chicken?
Just the packet of putrefaction.
Yeah.
God. Now we have a lovely beverage.
We need to... Oh, that's disgusting. Oh, God. If we could only smell through the video camera. You just smell...
From the beginning, please. Supposed to come in.
Are we continuing with this punch thing? Or
yes.
Yes, dear.
Okay.
Neck, chest. Up. That was just about perfect.
I slipped at the beginning.
That's it. That's no, for that song, yeah.
Okay. Again.
Again, just listen to the cymbal. Good?
Yeah.
Cool. Tick, tick, tick. Tick, tick. One left. Picking 186, 12.
We have another hour, right?
Yeah.
Well, I can't believe my eyes and ears. We just got back home from the studio and listened to the recording, what we did, and listened to Sam's recording of Massacre that we did through his heavy metal pedal straight into the desk through a chorus. So it's really good that I got like a copy of it, yeah, to have a listen to, because, oh God, we'd be wasting even more money. So, I don't know. Yeah, cool.
It's only like, how much is left there?
2,485.
Where does it all go, huh? Who knows, who knows?
Boy.
So when I go back to Australia, I started looking at studios, and you know, they basically wanted like $700 a day, and I was going to need at least 10 days, and it was $7,000, and you know, I had less than $2,000 left. So it very quickly became apparent that that was not going to be an option.
And then when he came back and was just like going, oh, I'm having some troubles, might need to use you for recording in Australia. I shat myself. I was like, whoa, Christ, I'm going to like record in a Euro album. Wow.
My only idea was to try and buy a computer and record the album myself. So anyway, I just started looking and ended up buying a computer for about $2,200 and $700 for a sound card. And I really don't remember where the extra money came from because I had no savings left.
All right, here we are about 1 month later, back home, trying it all again. Hopefully things are going to come together this time.
Things will come together.
Using the Marshall 2000 here.
It's hard for us to record guitars because I wasn't a normal guitarist. I didn't have a proper guitar rig. I paid absolutely no attention to getting a sound or even like what pickups I was using. And all that had to change when Luke came in.
Got the Seymour Duncan pickups. Got the guitar custom set to tune A. We've got the Marshall in here.
You got the talent.
Got the talent.
We modified the only guitar I had, got new pickups in that, and when we were doing experiments for getting the guitar sound, we got the JCM 2000, and straight off the bat got probably the most monstrous guitar tone ever.
We'll just give you a bit of a listen to the sound we've got happening. There it is coming out of there.
To A, which is basically deeper than just about every other band out there, and made playing the guitar extremely difficult because the strings would flop around like spaghetti.
If I can try the guitar shit again, doesn't work.
Madness! We've got 10 guitars up. No, we've got 8. Sorry, we've only got 8 guitars.
So far.
We've only got 8. We've got 8 guitars up there, sounding bigger than Jesus. As a dry sound, this thing is going to rip, and once we layer all the vocals, it's all coming together. Thank fuck for that. Big. Big. Big.
Never understand why.
So there I was, I had a Pentium 3 450 and a program that I'd never used before, and that presented an amazing amount of challenges. Just getting to know how to use a computer was enough in itself.
Beautiful. All right, number 10. You ready?
Yeah.
You ready to fucking go?
Hurry! Probably a little easier for Luke to record with me as far as the vocals were concerned, just because I'd already like done them for the demo. I was more familiar with them and could just go in and just blaze out take after take.
No man! No man! No!
Okay. Do you want to have a listen back to that?
Yeah.
Because you just have to be careful with some of the timing.
Oh, yeah.
Horrific side, with inches forming life, and all is left inside, confusion's in our mind, and lock us out!
I was having problems just with the voice. The main problem was getting, I think, the volume of my vocals right. And quite often I'd have to do about 20 minutes of screaming before any vocal takes were even attempted.
You were up for another one, or you had a five? I'll give you a 10-second break if you want.
Yeah.
One, two. How was that for you, mate?
Feels good.
All right in the headphones?
Yeah.
Beautiful.
The anguish of the night! The anguish of the night!
Once again, that was just like through lack of studio experience or really any experience whatsoever.
Okay, here we are, day two. As we can see, the VPR is in. The deep top is out, bass is on 10, rah, rah, rah. Mid boost is out, volume's on 10, and the gain, 7 and a bit.
We're just putting down the drums for the form, and there's Sam practicing away nice and hard. Berserker Home Studios, you can see there the Red Marshal of Death.
Here is the beast about to be unleashed.
Focus lock.
Amp is really cool. I think we need distortion pedals. Here's the death metal distortion settings.
It looks something like that.
When it came to EQing the guitar, just getting a guitar sound in general, I really had no idea that it was much better to do that within the context of the music. And, you know, here we were just trying to get a good guitar sound on its own, which was to haunt me later in the mixing stage.
This is the one we've decided on. It's loop number 8.
So we're gonna start to record now, so I'll keep you all updated. We'll try and film a little. Now we're about to record Pain. And we're about to do the tape trick.
Okay, we're utilising the Joe McKenna voiceover demo here.
Yes.
And we're just going to slip this in under the bridge. I think the strings are a bit loose.
Yeah, all right, now drop it on it. Beautiful. Now try it with Pain. Beautiful.
I'd sleep in the studio on a bunch of cushions on the studio floor.
Gotta get up early tomorrow, keep recording the album.
I'd usually wake him up because the room with the guitar amp in it was just next to his bedroom, and I'd plug in, turn on, and then just spend about half an hour warming up playing old death metal songs like Morbid Angel. Strangely enough, he'd only wake up when I started playing Carcass.
Okay, here we go.
Recording the guitars for the album was done in 5 days. I took a week off from work and I just play for hours every day. I think we do about 12 to 13 hours of just non-stop guitars.
Ice, snow, bitches.
Doing Massacre was very difficult because Luke wanted the most impossible riff in the world played at the most impossible speed, and he just wouldn't take no for an answer, and I'd have to do this riff again and again and again and do it again, and it was impossible to get even one time around.
Well, I was close.
Give it a break for a minute.
Sure. Oh, stop! Stop!
It wasn't a case of we tried it for a couple of hours and then went, alright, it isn't working, let's do something else. We tried it for a day, and then picked it up the next day and tried it again for hours. And that really did my arm in. That destroyed my arm.
We've been going at it since about 10 a.m. this morning.
Oh, good God, hardcore.
No, I know we have.
Fuck you.
Week would ruin my roofs pretty much. I'd give him these beautiful perlo roofs very, very close to my heart and give it to him, and he'd do what I call berserkerize. He'd berserkerize my riffs and give them back to me, like play 100 times faster or whatever. So I originally gave him these massacre riffs, the main one. It originally went. We speeded it up for the demo a little bit, fair enough. So we had this like charging little song, like going. Still could down pick, no problem. Something happened to him in Canada, I think. He sped it up even more and came back with it, and it was just like. And he was like, right, you gotta have a down pick like that, so we got the same feel. And I was like, back then, I wouldn't say no to anything. That was the one thing I think I nearly went, nah, no way, impossible to.
It's not, mate, it's not.
I can't even fluke it, man.
No, you can fluke it, you can do it.
I can't even fucking fluke that, no way.
Not bad, not bad. Better, better. Great. See, that's fucking almost there, mate. That's great. Think about it, mate, when it's done and people go, what the fuck? Brutal.
We're doing reality now. Lovely. It's going good. I'm just really tired.
Do it again. Stop!
Stop, did you say?
Stop! Bit behind the eight ball.
Again.
That's right, again. You ready?
Yes.
Here we go. Up! We've got to get one of those clean.
Yep.
This is the last one. Well, no, it's not the last one. But...
No, the last one for a little while. Give my arm.
All right, here we go.
I think that might have
won.
Might have been out a little.
I think it might have been out a little also. Have your break. Rub your arm.
Thank you.
Do all your exciting Chinese remedies. No.
I'll play for the camera.
I play for the camera. Well, there's not too much need of that. We'll just do another take. Hang on a minute. Gotta do it all, mate. Gotta get it crazy.
What's gonna happen when you die, man? You're gonna go to hell. There's gonna be a fucking devil there. He's gonna give you a guitar and it's gonna go, right.
You have to play it now.
Yes, your turn, motherfucker. Yes.
Give me the keyboards and I'll program it again. Okay, here we go.
Bring it on.
Okay, then. Well, you got two more sessions, mate. And then you're done.
Do it again. Do it again. Do it again. Get it right. Yeah, nice. Want to do another take. Do it again. Do it again. Get it right.
You're always fucking sleepy. Wait a minute, how much sleep did you get last night? Enough? Never enough. That's why it's a girl. Tradition's lost. Thoughts are changing. Unnaturally. That was beautiful.
First part of that was okay.
Alright.
First was shit ass. We had this other guy come in amongst the slew of musicians we used to like shoot our way through. It was called Sam. We decided that we couldn't have two Sams working in the studio, and as he was the younger one and I had seniority, he would be called Toby.
Devouring my last rites to have my life taken away.
I found the recording process of the first album quite interesting. price that I'd never been in a recording studio before, so I was like a kid in a candy store.
Like me, he originally came in and got involved because he played guitar. He was, I think, a bit slow, like learning some of the guitar parts, but the vocals, he had this most brutal scream on it.
Devouring my last rose to have my life taken away, inheriting the skill zone, because that is our only way.
I also found it quite draining. I heard the words "do it again" quite a lot. Do it again, do it again, do it again. That seems to be one of Luke's favourite words.
And what's more is he had both Luke and myself on either side of him, pretty much. We were a little cruel. Just going, do it again, get it right, do it again, that's shit, come on, what are you? And just like giving an absolute hell.
Is that getting worse?
There's two sections there. Well, we'll have a listen to it in a minute. Yeah. Well, we'll just try one then.
That sounds okay. Shit, that yeah, scream. But do you know what I mean?
Yeah, sure. Well, you want to try it again? Get it right?
Yep.
That started off quite good.
The Berserker being such a fast band, the music needs to be played with precision, and if it's not, then it needs to be recorded again and again and again. And that's tended to be what I heard quite a lot. Do it again, do it again, do it again. But that's okay.
That was really close, just the end fucking died, yeah. Didn't it? But that was really nice, the start of it.
Do it again, 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 do it again. Yeah, that was pretty good, but do it again. Yeah, that, we could probably use that, yeah, but do it again anyway.
Yeah, do some more, hang on, let me just throw this one down here. Go for it. Yeah, if you can get it, it'll be fucking great.
So you reckon that sounds all right?
Yeah, that's cool, that's good. Very good. All right, here we go.
Because we need to get the album done as quickly as possible, we were recording pretty much right through the night, and that presented some problems as far as people were trying to sleep in the house. So basically, I got someone in, and we knocked out the cupboards and built a vocal booth, which then allowed us to record 24/7 without disturbing anyone, and that's what we did.
Come on, mate! Do the fucking thing!
There was one time we just wanted him to go into the vocal booth and just give us a few screams. And he'd had a sore throat that had been hanging around for a while, which was not good enough of an excuse back in those days. And he just flat out said no, and we were like, just at least give it a shot. And he was like, no. And I think we probably ended up pressuring him a bit too much.
What's on with Cowboy? Fucking asleep, mate.
Hey, you fuck.
Oh, fuck. We originally tried doing the Massacre vocals at the speed at which they ended up on the CD. That didn't really work. We needed an extra mouth, maybe another three or four lungs. To get the extra bit of raspiness in the throat, I was drinking chocolate milk. And I'd always have a certain brand of chocolate milk I'd always drink, so it'd always sound like I was bubbling my vocals up through mud or something.
For a song like Massacre, where the vocal rhythms are, you know, really fast and quite long, we had some trouble getting through the whole song without punching in. So I decided that we'd record the vocals at half speed and then time stretch them later, which is what we did. So I really wasn't sure what style of vocal I wanted to have on Massacre, and I thought I might go for some kind of wet, gargly sound. So I ended up chewing five or six Starburst lollies while we were doing the take, and somewhere in here I ended up choking on it, which didn't make it onto the album.
That's a bit better.
Are you getting that in the studio?
What's that, mate? The slap? We're getting a bit of slap. Are you awake?
Yeah, let's go.
Alright, here we go, mate.
Endless panorama of desolation and death.
One and two and three and four and...
Just do a couple more and we'll cut them up. Let me know when you're ready, mate.
More problems I faced doing vocals later on was not only just that I was really, really, really tired and exhausted, but just I was having troubles just, I guess, staying focused. The tiredness would mean that I just lose concentration, lose timing, and lose total interest in what I was doing. So I'd have to slap myself, and even then that wasn't like doing anything, so I'd have to start like biting myself like really damn hard just to like shock myself awake. And then eventually that wasn't even doing it.
How you doing, mate? How many more you want to do, or what's your plan? You want to do a couple more?
Yeah, I can do another one or two.
Another one or two.
Let's try one guttural, all low. You know, don't worry about coming up at all. Just fucking. Let's just try a couple of different things, and then we'll cut them up.
Great, I think the start of that was fantastic. Let's just have a quick listen.
So as far as my vocals were concerned, I mean, I had to record them all myself. I would do the recording through the night after I recorded everyone else, and there was no one left to help me. So what I'd do, I'd set what I thought was a rough level on the preamp and run into the vocal booth and do a little bit of vocals and then come out and check it and see that it was too loud or too soft, and I ended up putting the computer monitor, or aiming it so I could see it through the window in the booth, and made things a little bit easy, but it was just lots of, you know, forward and backward to get it right. And once I finally got it right, it was basically set a really long pre-roll and hit record and run in and do a take. But again, this didn't allow for any punch-ins or any of that kind of thing, so it was really just had to do it and get it right, which I guess really wasn't too much of a problem for me because I'm so familiar with the music. But it was definitely a very, very interesting way to work.
It's the once again we got someone else working on the fucking the massacre riff here, the damn picking master.
God fucking damn, this is impossible. We will get this. We will down pick this riff.
Sure, of course you will, mate. We're just approaching the second hour.
Nice.
Yeah,
okay.
pathologist has to determine is the identity of the deceased, the time of death, and the cause of death.
Death, to me, implies life.
Pathologist has to determine is the identity of the deceased, the time of death, and the cause of death.
Death, to me, implies life.
It's the, once again, we got someone else working on the fucking, the massacre riff here, the damn picking master.
God fucking damn, this is impossible. We will get this. We will down pick this riff.
Sure, of course you will, mate. We're, just approaching the second hour.
Nice.
Yeah,
okay.
So Sam had recorded most of the songs, but there were still a few that were incomplete. He'd gone for a holiday up the coast, and during the time he was away, I'd started thinking that it'd be a good idea to re-record a different guitar sound to pan to one side, and we could pan the one we'd already done to the other side, just to add a little bit more depth to the overall sound. So I was out at a gig one night, and I saw this fantastic band called The Wolves, and I just went up and approached them after the show and asked them if they'd be interested in helping me out with this project.
I was playing a gig with one of my old bands, with Jace. I got approached by this guy called Luke, who was putting together some metal album, some extreme metal project. I asked for our help, basically. He was really looking to complete the album, and he threw a whole bunch of material at us, and that's how we were introduced, just like that. Luke just came across with just an enormous amount of enthusiasm, which was a breath of fresh air, really. And that just seemed to indicate that there was something going on here that I guess we wanted to be a part of. And you know, any musical project with, you know, such a push or a driving force is what you look for when you're trying to achieve anything in music. And I guess that's what just made us really just take the stuff and go learn it. So during our conversation, we asked, you know, so when are you doing this? And he said, I'm doing it now. So it was like, okay, it was a real fly-by-night affair. We just picked up the stuff and took it home, and I think that night we just got to it and put the CD on and sat down and started learning. And
we just sort of swapped guitars every now and then, just gave it a go. And
within a couple of days, we started getting phone calls, to, you know, basically hurrying us up to learn this stuff.
One guitar and a click track. That was all we really had to go by.
And of course we were busting our ass trying to learn these riffs. We'd never heard anything of the Berserker before.
We had, you know, no drums, nothing to put it into context. It was really just a guitar track.
We'd only learnt bits and pieces of the songs. I had learnt some riffs, Ed had learnt some riffs.
Didn't know whether it would be good enough or not. Just tried to get to sounding as much as we could, like, you know, what we were given.
And then we pretty much just went, okay, well, let's go find out what's going on with this stuff that we've been learning. And just pretty much just went in there and started trying to get a guitar sound. I went in there with my trusty 5150 thinking that it was going to do the job. We tweaked around for about, oh, it must have been 36 hours of just turning knobs. And eventually we just got to the point where the old 5150 wasn't going to work, and Luke's idea of a Marshall had to happen.
We need a Marshall!
5150 challenge, another country, another day. I'm not sure if it's ever going to work.
For some reason, Luke thought the Marshall sounded better, and I guess I had to agree, it was a pretty fat sound.
So what's the plan for tomorrow? We're going to get into it?
We're going to get a Marshall,
sure.
JCM900.
Sure. And
come back.
Now what's the deal in the morning? You want me to come over and wake you up? So 11 o'clock, sure.
You've got us on tape now. Is he serious half the time? We didn't know if he was serious, if he was joking.
The place doesn't open for me, though.
Sure, so why? That's right, so gives you plenty of time to get up. Fuck.
So we wake up. No, that's not it.
We just come here at 11 o'clock.
That's it.
And we don't worry about all that waking up shit. It just complicates shit.
That's right.
We just come here at 11.
Sure.
But, you know, you got this feeling that it was really trying to get the job done, and I guess we were there in the thick of it.
Get the marshal and come here. Right?
After we dialed up the guitar tones, we just pretty much just started laying down some tracks. But all this was happening while we were just getting to know each other. We didn't know each other. We just walked into the studio and hardly knew the songs, and we started recording, and slowly, slowly we started to get to know each other over the next couple of weeks tracking the guitars. Which was very interesting. Interesting way to work.
Came in the wrong time, didn't do enough.
I think you're right. We've done the right thing, man. I really don't.
We didn't know what the boundaries were.
You want to listen?
Oh,
nah, fuck. I fuck listening to it.
You want to listen to it?
Nah, I don't.
Well, I'll go. Do you know how to go?
No.
Well, then we should listen to it.
I mean, you know, I've been doing recordings for, you know, a few years up until that point, so I was familiar with the recording environment, but not this one. This one was very different.
I can't do it for that long, mate.
Oh, you're joking? Come on, mate.
I cannot do it for that long. That is ridiculous.
I made Sam do it four times, mate.
This was a small confinement, and it was straight onto a, you know, the PC, and it was a click track, but it was there was no punching. There was no, we can edit this to that. It was, do it. Just do it.
So that's, how's it go?
It goes like this. It
goes for double that.
Fuck that.
Fuck, I'll give you one more shot. You gotta fucking, you gotta go through the pain, man. You gotta get to the pleasure.
Want me to try that one?
Yeah.
You gotta be your arms just a bit. You got any footage of Sam doing this?
You ready? All right, man. When you run out of energy, where's a pick? You use that, all right? Give me that. When you run out of energy, you tell me.
Look at these dicks.
Alright, so that's how you do it.
Let's go.
Okay, we're going 8 in. Oh, what the fuck's that?
Start it again, mate.
Fuck, is this going to be another 56 takes?
Maybe.
Alright, here we go.
Maybe if you looped it.
Fucking looped it. More. Have a listen to this shit, maybe, if you looped it.
His approach to achieving things was just ridiculous half the time. But I guess we just had to go along, because this wasn't our baby. It was Luke's project, and he wanted things done a certain way, and we'd agreed to do it. So there we were.
What happened?
Roll the... It's so fucking hard to... Volume knob rolls itself off.
That's black, man. That's black.
That's some black magic trying to tell us that we're not fucking black enough for this shit.
Oh my god!
Fuck this.
Oh, that's pitiful, mate. You both didn't get as far as Ed got before, and Ed didn't even get half as far as Sam got in one take.
I'm sorry, that looks about half, mate.
You fucking suck.
Yeah, we got a marshal.
Sure.
Because we didn't know the songs from start to finish, We ended up playing parts of songs. I'd play a part and Eddie would play a part, and so it went for the whole recording process.
Just got dun 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 dun. Yeah, here we go.
I didn't know how to take Luke when I first met him. No idea. Couldn't read him to save myself. But that was alright. I just did what I had to do there, and that was cool. And, you know, once I got past the stage of being, you know, utterly offended at everything he had to say or wanted me to do, and realised how to read him right, and that was just sort of like, you know, do what you gotta do just to get something done. Got along really well with him. But this was squashed into like 2 weeks. So, just like the music, that was a pretty extreme experience.
Do you know what happened? I looked up to see how many more times I had to do it. So how many times do you want to do it?
I don't know.
Can I have a listen?
Sure thing.
Sweet.
Never played in that tuning that low before. That style of playing with that low, that kind of low tuning was different. It was definitely a different attack to playing like that. And yeah, the picks obviously sort of had to be a lot thinner.
Stop laughing, do it again.
What interested me in doing this project was that I wasn't familiar with this sort of style of playing, particularly with the right arm, the rapid fire approach with the trill picking and stuff like that. So it was interesting to sort of give that a go, and stamina was definitely something I had to work on. That was a good challenge for me, sort of, you know, try and get the fast riffs down.
Why don't we keep going?
And like the whole thing was just, you know, play faster and lower and harder and heavier and longer. It never stopped.
You wrote this on the fucking keyboard, didn't you?
Glad I did.
I've never ever had my chops up as good as I have to when I was recording the Berserker album. Even to this very day, I can't play that fast. Now, I couldn't play that fast before. Somehow there was just the approach and how it was sort of manipulated and, you know, do it again and, you know, whatever. I've never played that good ever since.
Want to keep hacking at it?
Yeah, for sure.
Alrighty.
Alright. Or fast, or low, or angry.
How do you, like, zoom in and zoom out, whatever?
Just
whatever.
Zoom button with the fucking zoom button, that's it.
Is it? Oh.
Oh.
Ah!
Here,
funny.
You got ya?
Yeah. You're funny.
Good, except that.
Can you give us that hand movement again, mate? Give some Hendrix,
that's
Jay.
Your third warning, mate.
Oh, that's one more.
That time. Was so not a Hendrix song.
I don't care.
One more time and I'm retired.
And I fucking give you the gold plate and masturbate a pair. Oh. Here we go.
It's got to get really good attack on it to make sure it fucking comes out at the bow. It's going to leak down like a poker.
No squeaks, right?
No.
No, I don't think it's quite what we're looking for. Right.
You didn't like it?
No.
Next song.
Fucking 60 takes and we don't like it.
Are you serious? You don't like it? What is it that you don't like about it, man?
Well, there's two fucking different guitar riffs and that sounds messy.
No, I mean, do you like the one you did? Because Sam's coming in to do his again.
I love that one.
Yeah, you like it?
Nah, it's alright.
Yeah.
This is what he feeds us. He feeds us ice cream. Oh, shit. That's some ice cream. It was like Luke was Satan and he was whipping us with this thing called a berserker just to get it done this particular way. And we had to grow horns.
So, just let me know, if are the guitar techs going to have tape on them at all times?
No, this is just a studio trick.
Studio trick. We can't talk about that because that's a secret.
Right. Shocking. If Luke was here, he'd fuck.
See, if Luke was here, he would just be spewing about that F sharp chord. You just can't have chords like that.
Oh, that was alright, mate.
That was
alright. Just warming up. Just warming up. Here we go.
Usually when we'd go into a studio to record, we'd know what we were playing. We'd have an idea of how we wanted things to sound. But this time it was out of our hands. It was in somebody else's hands that we didn't really know that well.
You've got to pretend to play it even if you don't.
Come on!
Okay, this is the 75th, this is the lucky one, mate.
Luke had a real particular way that he wanted everything done, you know. Even though we were recording direct to digital and the possibilities that that opens up with, you know, punching things in and out, moving stuff around, he wanted it recorded like it was on 2-inch analog, you know, in the 70s.
Do it again, do it again.
You want another one?
I'll give you another one.
106 takes, and we still haven't got it. Can I have 107th, or do we have to take
it? No, 107th would be the lucky.
I think it was 120 odd takes of this song.
The picking is good, but the rhythm is.
I know the problem. It's the wrong colour, mate. What colour are you? What colour are you? You're the.
Let's fucking hit it.
He wanted one take to be the song. He wanted everything just perfect and done in this particular way. If there was a really fast one, it had to be down peak.
Not bad, but the rhythm is wrong.
We gotta get this. We have to get this.
Just get the rhythm right first, mate.
All right.
That was it, mate. Well, let's just get it. Let's get it on, huh?
That was it, man. Don't delete it.
Too late, mate. You can do a better one than that.
Fuck. All right, all right.
You can, mate. I can hear it.
Since then, I've learned to keep everything.
It was only because I had no idea of what I was doing that I thought we'll just delete it and we'll get a better one. But that wasn't the case.
It's not going to be horrible, mate. We're going to have to the 10th take and then stop.
You've got to keep one of my takes.
Sure, mate. I'll keep one of them. I'll keep the right one.
All right.
That's what we need. Here we go.
It was all about integrity and making this the most badass album anyone's ever done, and it's forever, and you know, this is for life, and it's going down on tape, and you're never going to get to do this again, and all this real extreme stuff.
Keep that.
Fucking awful, mate. Okay, we go again.
It's a bit of a pressure cooker. There was Sam sitting across the room watching what we were doing, making sure we had the riffs right.
15 seconds.
15 seconds, 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 13, 15, here we go. So this is the walk in the park, mate, when you get into the groove.
It is.
It is. You've just got to...
Keep that too.
No, that was the wrong rhythm.
What have you got to say?
Well, we're here at the Berserker's house, doing guitar tracks for his upcoming album. And we've been here for the last week.
We're out of battery.
It got to the point where I guess everyone got sick of hearing and playing the riffs. I guess the thing that they didn't realise is I'd already spent a year trying to record the album, teaching, rehearsing, pre-production with about 7 different guitarists, you know, both in Australia and Canada, and my patience was just about out.
There was definitely a part, I think, where Luke sort of just couldn't take it anymore, and here I am thinking, you know, we're the victims, and then before you knew the tables had turned, and then you know it was just myself and Jason in front of the computer because Luke was somewhere else in another room, just totally fried by the whole experience. So but you know, it wasn't long till he was back in there and saying do it again.
You want to go again or you want to keep that one? That was perfect. It took us behind.
They finally got to the stage where, you know, I thought their playing was good enough, and they were telling me that they could do it better and let's do it again. So, quite amusing.
Nice.
Yeah, that's metal!
Nice, but it could have been better.
Yeah, that was it.
That was the tape.
That was it, mate.
That's so metal.
Let's have a listen.
We're all happy with it?
Yes.
Do it again.
I don't know.
Oh, you can have a listen.
A bit of a...
It's got to be bang. It's got to be clean from nothing. If you want to punch in, it's got to be...
No punch in. No.
Oh, that's, well, this is a punch in.
All right. Behind 3/4 of the way through.
You sound pretty.
Sound pretty good. Let's fucking quickly do another one.
That was it. That was the take.
We had character. Let's have a listen.
Character. Here we go.
But I have to be doing power chords, right?
Yep. It's his fault.
It's my fault. I'll take all responsibility.
With Massacre, for example, we'd be there. Now, there's no need to downpick that fast under any circumstances. No one should try it that quick. It's ridiculous. It's a waste of time. There's no need for it. But we had to do it because Luke said that that's the way he wanted it done. And we were there trapped.
Two words. Down pick.
Alright, while this damn camera's here and you can hear the click.
Yeah.
Let's want the whole world to know
that
this dude was going to down pick this fast.
Do you want to start at a slower speed, mate, and then work up to it?
Can't go up. No ups. Can't go up and down. Down. That's it.
Can't even down pick one note that fast. Impossible.
Don't you say a word around it, it'll just make you fucking go out of
it's there. Impossible!
Oh, you got it, mate. Do you want me to slow it down again?
I don't slow it down, man.
Yeah.
It's gotta be what it's supposed to be.
Down picking at that speed is just is a sure way to get yourself hospitalised. Yeah, I'm happy to be alive.
Can he put it to the normal speed? You just have to completely go.
Normal speed?
Normal speed. I mean, that's not.
Here we go.
This, which is great, isn't it? Yeah, I've got a chance. Maybe yeah. It's like.
Yeah. I'm just gonna keep recording, just go. Fuck it up, start, wait two, go again.
I don't really know the riff that well.
You'll learn it in
wanna,
a jazz, in a sniffy.
I wanna just practice, like.
Don't worry, mate. Okay, here we go. You all taped up?
I didn't do it. How do you do it? I've never done it before. Oh, I go under the strings. Beautiful.
Well, I don't know. That's how Jay did it. Tune first before we do the perfect take. Oh, it's been a hard day. Only mentally stressful.
Yes, it's been a day for learning.
Not hard work.
It's been a day for learning many things.
Many things, like don't ever use humans again. I'm ready, are you ready? Again, again, again. Let's go, let's go.
Perfect, you're ready.
Perfect. Okay, anytime, yeah?
Anytime, mate. Still good, twice. Yeah, good one. Here we go. Come on, fuck! You gotta go like this. Come on, fuck, fuck! But that's what you did last time, and then you got it. So try it again. Come on, fuck, right, fuck! It was this little jump
be,
thing.
There'll
it's
be
a jump maneuver.
That.
Okay.
Plenty of that, don't worry.
Alright, well, here we go. Halt! Okay, 3 second break.
Just a bit longer.
Alright, 5 second break. You ready?
Go for it.
Back. Yeah! Yeah!
Oh, fucking bitch!
Do you want to halt for a minute? Was that last one any good?
You can listen to it.
You can listen to it.
Yeah, sloppy as they go.
Sloppy as they go, yes. So last riff we've been on for 3 days now. It's one riff. Well, not 3 days, but all day today. We got one riff done today, black metal. And I think now it's starting to make itself a little clearer, and that is the fact that they are doing it as some sort of sick, perverted torture to me, for me, with me. Goodbye.
Yeah. Whilst recording, Luke was pretty feisty, just trying to get things done his way. And a lot of the time it was pretty ridiculous for us, but, you know, we played along because we didn't really know him well enough to go, hey, shut the fuck up. If we had told him to shut the fuck up, I probably wouldn't be sitting here right now.
Okay, here we go.
We resorted to doing things like getting psyched up, you know, going out and slapping ourselves and coming back in the room and trying to record this ridiculously fast riff, down picked, with no punchings.
The four, okay.
I'll take my head off today.
And it just got to the point where I'd been down picking, just my elbow was rubbing up against the chair, and it just eventually just wore off the skin. So I had to just tape it up and keep going.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, you ready to try it again? There we are, mate. It's like a weight. It'll make your fucking arm stronger. You want me to... Here we go, mate. Come on, we haven't gone all night. We got it. Don't worry about the scissors. Just try it. No, just try it. Fucking Jesus. You ready? Yeah. This is the last one we're doing. Long as you can go, mate. Here we go. Yeah, that was good. Here we go. That's alright, mate. It's alright. No, it is doing
it's
it for
really
you,
hurting.
Mate. No! You've got to get into the thing, mate!
Like that?
Yes! Go again! Come on!
What is that?
Oh!
I take it off so it's lighter.
And it's amazing that it actually got it done with the roll of tape on it.
Oh. That's
just cut it.
Just so I can bend my elbow.
Oh! Yeah!
Relief.
Ah! I'm bleeding!
After just struggling for hours and hours, you eventually just reach a point where you just crack and you get it done. To this day, I haven't had to do that, thank Christ, but yeah, it was an experience. Deep down inside, through all these painful periods, I think there was some sadistic thing going on there where, you know, like, we just enjoyed hurting ourselves to get this thing done. And in the end, we managed to turn it into some kind of positive experience, which it was. It was definitely positive, but yeah, I still think about it.
The end. Good night. Thanks for coming. That's done. I've had enough. Perfect.
Enough.
Give me five. How's your arm, mate?
There it is. Can I get it closer?
Sure.
That's what happens. Got the bit where you got smashed up against the chair there.
Oh, I got smashed, right. But don't you feel a little bit more like a man now?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind doing this again, you know.
Once the guitar tracks were done, it was time to do bass. So we went and borrowed our bass player's gear and brought it down. And it was a really weird bass rig set up.
What the hell's that on? No one knows.
It was just a 1/15-inch cabinet. And it was so quiet.
Whatever, there's the mic, a million miles away from it. And that's how loud it is. Pretty cool, huh? That's how loud it is getting the monster sound, mate. Look how far the mic is.
It ended up sounding huge.
Yeah?
Yeah.
By the time we started recording the bass, we had a real idea of how to work with each other and really started to enjoy it a lot more. And
that's a treat, man.
That's
the
a treat.
The bass just makes it go bam, 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 bam. And keep that one and just do another one.
Right, if I must.
It's fresh.
It's fresh, here we go.
Through the stressful experiences of songs like Massacre and Reality, we got to know each other a lot better, and there was a chemistry that started to happen between us, which was productive, and we really started to get things done.
Yeah!
Yeah.
I don't even know which bit you're trying. Oh, you're doing it. Which bit are you doing?
Oh,
damn,
my
bit you
God, keep up!
What are those vocals doing, mate? Who's fucking... Who programs this shit, man?
Mate, do it again.
I'm doing it all again.
Say goodbye. Say goodbye.
Say goodbye.
There wasn't as much scrutiny placed on the bass playing or anything like that. We were just grooving along and getting it done. I'd be playing some bass parts, Sam would be playing as well.
I had a good day today, with the bass down, pretty fucking killer sound. When we got into it, come together really good. It's all going it's all coming together slowly. So that's really good. I am reasonably happy.
Oh, come on.
Sorry, mate. Here we go.
Fucking shit, one more to go.
I know, that's what you get through every time.
Again,
here we go. That was the end, was that alright?
Yeah, that's good.
It was alright. Do you like the higher one?
No.
Can I hear the higher one?
Sure.
It's up to you ultimately.
It's got to work with the kick.
Usually!
I don't know.
High bass notes.
Which one did you just delete then?
Hi! You want to do something else?
It's that little... That's a bit messy. We want that.
I like the mess, it's lovely.
Was that crap or was that good?
Let's have a listen to it. If it does trick, don't. Let's go.
Man! Can you turn me up?
Nah, mate. Sorry.
I can't hear myself.
Do another one?
Yes, please. Here we go.
Hey, nice Sleepy. How Sleepy? Are you ready to go? Home to bed?
Yes.
And yeah, that pretty much wrapped it all up. It was good.
Crime.
It's really important for people to understand that, you know, they were not involved for financial reasons or because they had something invested in the project. It was for the love of the music. And I think that comes through.
It's been fucking a very interesting period with lots of computer fuck-ups and all the rest, and I decided that PCs are not the way to go, and we definitely need Macs or Pro Tools or something with some hardware DSP capability. Okay, I just had a call from Eric saying that the deadline has to be 15th of November, which is about 2.5 weeks. Having a lot of fucking problems with this thing, trying to do it on the PC, so it's now time to just commit. They want, I've got my fucking computer's doing now, but basically something like, yeah, I mean, the distributors need it and all the rest of it, which is fair enough, I understand all that. I mean, my computer's fucked. We'll see what happens over the next, 2.5 weeks, basically, but hopefully it fucking doesn't sound too bad, but what the fuck's wrong with you?
The recording itself was nightmarish, like, less so for me than it would have been for Luke. We'd do some awesome vocal takes sometimes, and I'd go back and the computer had thrown a fit, and, like, all those vocal takes would be gone.
It's the 27th of October. 1999. The PC's still sort of playing up, but it was all sort of going alright. I gotta finish the album cover.
And just as I'm about to send the bloody thing to fucking Earache, I spent all night last night getting it fixed. Computer goes down, I can't even bloody load the fucking thing. Gotta take it to the computer shop now and have it sorted out. So,
when will things start to go right, perhaps? Maybe when it's done.
Yeah, great. Here we are fucking installing Windows for the 6th time today. I don't know when this fucking shit will end, but I fucking wish it would, because I don't know how I'm gonna. No. Finally install all the fucking shit back on it. I don't know, what a day. Whatever doesn't kill me can only make me stronger, eh? And lo and behold, there it is. It's been a fucking long day and I've just had about enough.
What are you gonna do?
We've got a few more days marked up there.
Pretty exhausted last couple of days, so yeah. Fell asleep at the computer last night. Had to go to bed, I was making too many mistakes.
Maybe we'll put the song on? Are you gonna dance fast?
Yeah.
Fucking editing this shit, getting all the tracks together is taking a lot longer than I bloody thought. I'm only halfway through the fucking things. I spent all night on February trying to get these stupid fucking strings, so it'd be nice just to be able to get these bloody things down and start to mix it properly. I haven't really got anything exciting to look forward to. I've got bloody Massacre and fucking Reality coming up, so that'll be fun little edits, but at least it's all nice and tight and arranging the vocals. I suppose February was a big one.
So I was getting an engineer to help me out just with various things in the studio towards the end, the mixing process, and he was using a program called Vegas, and of course I was using Logic, and for some reason I decided to switch and go to Vegas, which sounded simple enough, but making sure that all the WAV files would sync, and I guess some of the tracks were, 26 tracks, it turned into an absolute nightmare.
I spent the last, I don't know how many fucking hours, probably about six,
merging all these bloody things, getting them all nice and neat so we can mix them and not fuck around. I don't even know why I'm doing it, but it's taking days, and I don't really have days. Anyway, I spent all this time doing this shit, and only now realise that when you fucking merge on this bloody thing, it merges in mono. It doesn't fucking even give you the option to merge in stereo, so I had to go back and fucking, I hope I don't have to re-record the bloody crashes and all that shit. But it's most probably likely whatever can go wrong. So anyway, it's an update on what's been happening, just learning Vegas tonight, and it's pretty cool. Just, it'd be fucking great if you could just use all the plugins and work, because I would have mixed the bloody whole thing by now. But anyway, what do we got happening here? Well, there we have it. Sounds a little something like that. Yeah, that's what fucks it up. Running all that shit. Ah, you fucking asshole, stop.
Because I had no prior experience recording instruments, I really didn't know about a lot of the time-saving tricks, you know, things such as, you know, noise gates. So I'm spending up to 6 hours a day cutting out the hum and hiss and the guitar amps, and then crossfading every cut. What would be a 5-10 minute job at the maximum, like I said, it was taking me 6 hours and it was starting to drive me insane.
Just trying to bloody working with these fucking computer things. It's a lot of work to get this shit together, all these guitars in the right fucking place, and getting them, making sure everything's properly bloody cut and this and that, and fucking, it took me about six hours to cut together Massacre today, which was fun. Yeah, I wouldn't mind to get bloody mixing on this shit, but geez, that's so fast. So much fucking, yeah, crazy shit, whatever. That's all lovely. Thank you very much. Bye.
That's a good way.
Good one. Yeah, just turn it down a touch. Oh, there's gotta be something in there. Just fuckerizing around with this bloody snare drum, there's some serious processing going down. So sounds like this. A hatchet will be used to spill in their skulls and actual flesh from their bodies. It's the nature of forcing blood. To inherit that skill, the dead, their relatives must.
I suppose I should record some bits when I'm actually smiling instead of always going, I hate doing fucking editing and stuff. But this song fucking rocks. The form with the drums cranking. I was worried I didn't have any fast, thrashy fucking tunes. And listen to that shit, man. I should stop listening to it and get back to work, but it's actually fun.
Yet again, we gotta fucking reinstall Windows because this
piece of shit fucking shit itself. 6 days left or whatever it is. There's me. There's the fucking computer. Re-fucking shitting itself again.
I reckon that that fucking studio's looking a hell of a lot better now that you have monster masks on both speakers.
Sure.
He asked the guy that was recording us what was going on. Could he help? Because he was in strife.
Any comments on the last couple of days' proceedings with this fucking album?
No comment.
No comment?
No comment.
Is that as good as it gets, mate?
That's about as good as I get.
So is that a good no comment or an awful good comment?
Oh, it's a great no comment. Yeah. I'm just over the moon about the whole thing. We still haven't got a song next.
Still trying to get it all happening. Not having any luck. It's either the kick or the guitars. We can't... both of them happening, and the guitar sound doesn't allow us to the kick to be heard or whatever. Very difficult.
Paul's guitar sound sounds great. Much better than the one we got. It's very clear. The old demo is very good. Fonted, you know, I wrote with the thing, with the keyboard thing.
Alright, I've changed the studio around once again. The last bloody time, set the speakers up like I used to have them, try and get some bass into this room to try and monitor properly. And as we can see here, if we have a look at the calendar, it's almost done. Today being, I suppose it's Saturday morning, isn't it? Early Saturday morning, 2:15. I've really fucking tried everything, every possible bloody thing. Greg fucking trying putting the guitars loud, the kicks soft and whatever and this and that, and just I can't do it here with this gear. It's just ridiculous. I've tried fucking every combination and I don't know what to say. I can't fucking do it. What am I supposed to say? I don't know. I just can't get the fucking it all. It's all this treble shit that I don't have the gear to separate, and it's the only thing I think I can do is talk to Eric about getting it mixed overseas somewhere with one of their guys they use, trying to get a good deal, and you know, me having to, I don't know, them trying to fit the bill, or if, you know, if they won't, I'll have to try and fit the bill to get it mixed overseas, but I can't do it here. I just need to concentrate on the live show, otherwise I'm just going to be so sick of this fucking music and trying to get it to sound good that I won't even want to do it. So I'm just going to try now and clean up everything, get it in order where it's all WAV files from where to go, all the right takes, all the vocals on the right channels, all that sort of stuff, because I can't do it. Yeah. Thank you and good night, I suppose. Just watched the footage from the last week or so, or whatever's on this tape. I had to listen to a few of the mixes and stuff. It's 321, there you go. They were on the tape that I was doing, the bit where the snare sounded really good and deformed and all that shit. I'm going to go through all of the different mixes and see if there's anything salvageable before I get too bloody carried away about sending it overseas. And I can get together about $700 anyway to do this mix fucking thing if I have to. To do it overseas. I prefer not to, but I just fucking, I don't know how to do it here. It's very hard. Very, very hard. Anyway, I don't want to waste this tape on this shit, but I don't give a fuck who mixes it, but I'm not, and that's the end of it. It's fucking Tuesday. I come in here, I've taken the fucking days off because I said I wasn't going to do this bullshit. I come in here for fucking, all right, I'm going to do it now. I'm going to fucking do it all. I've been in here 45 fucking minutes trying to get one fucking snare drum off a fucking CD. Now I gotta reinstall Windows again. This is fucking bullshit and I'm sick of it. Today is Thursday morning the 18th, about 6:15. Just read an interview with Dig in some magazine. Basically, the most extreme band on Earache is the Berserker. In fact, it's the most extreme band on the planet. I'll send you a copy, blah blah blah. Which is fucking great, because that is the plan. It's just unfortunate that this fucking album's not all that it could be, because it just fucking ripped motherfuckers' heads off like it's supposed to.
And I think that's sort of like the thing that Luke and I think about when we look back at the first album, is that it's turned out okay, like considering how much shit was going on at the time, but it could have been a hell of a lot better because we lost a lot of sounds and a lot of good takes and stuff we lost as well.
It's bloody 5:45 in the morning now and I had to go back, those files fucking shit themselves and turn into, the kicks turn into guitars and all that sort of crazy shit. I finally, now I just fucking got it. Lucky I checked back over that because the discs I already fucking recorded, the crazy shit had happened with the kicks and all that, so I'm going to have to double check all this as well. Whatever can go wrong, eh? Fucking, man. 7:54, I finally fucking got all that shit back together, the guitars and all the bloody snares and all that crap, and finally checked them all so I know they all work now. As you can see, it's a lovely day out. But anyway, it's all done and it's checked, so now I'm just doing some backups. On that demo there, there's a few sounds and a few vocals that aren't actually in there. And, you know, there was a few samples missing, that and, you know, this and that, and rah, rah, rah. But as I say, it wasn't mixed, it was just fucking levels were turned up. Let me have a listen to it, yeah? Because I haven't listened to it since I sent it to you guys, like, the first time. Yes. Fuck, alright. Okay, now that was Dig saying, that was Hugh saying that Dig doesn't want to put any more money into it. He wants to master it next Tuesday. They want me just to get the roughs. And, whatever, just do it like that. But those roughs are pretty rough, so I'm going to have to go through now, have a listen to everything, just get some rough levels happening. And, anyway, more work for me!
It's amazing what people have put themselves through for music. End.